When the worst mass shooting in modern U.S. history occurred in October at this very spot, none of the unionized hotels in Las Vegas gave their workers panic buttons, including the Golden Mandalay Bay, where the gunman rained down bullets and terror on the crowd below. Now, less than a year later, all of the major hotels give panic buttons like this one to their workers.
You can click this as many times as you want, and now the alert's gone off.
It says right here, SOS alert activated.
That's right.
New portable panic buttons like these from React Mobile use small Bluetooth beacons to solve a big problem. GPS, like in your smartphone, determines a person's location based on latitude and longitude, but not which floor of a high-rise hotel you're on. Bluetooth beacons, however, can triangulate your position down to within 5 to 10 feet, allowing first responders to know which floor and which room a victim of a shooting, assault, or medical emergency is in.
Typically, we'll put them somewhere that's out of sight.
The beacons work with panic devices on iPhones, keychains, and wearables, costing about 70 cents to $2 per room from a host of tech companies. CEO Rob Monkman.
We want to give people a useful tool that can protect their loved ones.
The union that represents 57,000 hotel workers here in Las Vegas and in Reno did have one big concern about panic buttons: digital snooping.
It is a big concern.
Gioconda Aguello Klein leads the Hotel Workers Union in Las Vegas, which got major hotels there to promise not to continuously track workers. Members had voted in May to authorize a strike if they didn't get panic buttons.
You gave the hotels an ultimatum.
We say we need this. We need this because it's protecting people's lives.
Hotels in New York and D.C. also provide panic buttons as part of union contracts. They're required by law in Seattle, Chicago, and Miami Beach, Florida. But not everyone supports them. The city council in Long Beach, California voted not to require them.
Finance is opposed to this bill.
And a bill that would have required them statewide died last month in a Senate committee. The American Hotel and Lodging Association, the industry trade group, once promised to fight back, slamming the devices as a solution in search of a problem. But now, amid union protests at hotels coast to coast, the major hotel brands are reversing their past opposition. On Thursday, we've learned the AHLA and the CEOs of Hilton, Hyatt, IHG, Marriott, and Wyndham are scheduled to hold a joint news conference to announce an employee safety initiative that will go far beyond the slice of hotel workers that are union members and impact hundreds of thousands of employees.
One of the guests, he offered me money to actually have a sex with him.
You were offered money by a guest?
Yes, by
for
a guest
sex act.
For a sex act.
Dayami Santos, a hotel worker for 17 years and mother of three, hopes the Las Vegas hotel where she works will quickly follow suit.
If they would like to have their workers safe, they will do it.
Widespread emergency alert.
In Las Vegas, I'm Chief National Investigative Correspondent Mark Albert.